It's G out of Dawn. I got the skin for this. You know, I know what I signed up for. You gotta have the heart for the business. If you don't, it's like, it'll destroy you definitely.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the BBJ Show. Today we got Mr. I know it's been way too long. When you need me, anyway you need me. Mr. J.I., ladies and gentlemen. So, sit back, strap in, and be inspired. A la baby mucho gusto. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, J.I. is one of the freshest and the greatest kings on the block, ladies and gentlemen. And yeah, well, yes, he goes by the Prince of New York, ladies and gentlemen. Don't tell DJ somebody. I'm just kidding. Oh, 6ix9ine, man, marach. 6ix9ine is trash, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, young J.I. is a master battle rapper, melodic. Rapper, and he started freestyling when he was young, and man, he used to freestyle with his brothers, man. And then from there, he started dropping freestyles on Instagram. I also got freestyles on Instagram, so go check them out, ladies and gentlemen. And through social media, man, he found his way to make it on the Lifetime reality show named The Rap Game. Even though he didn't win, but he gained the clout and followers so he can what? Prosper and kill the game, ladies and gentlemen. His real name is Justin Rivera and was born on September 23rd and on September 23rd in 2001, and he grew up in Crown Heights, Franklin Avenue, Park Place in the Bronx. Yeah, man, grew up where Biggie Smalls grew up, Jay-Z grew up, damn, he's grew up, now you know, he grew up with the G's, ladies and gentlemen. So, yeah, man, his mom was his manager back in the day, but we'll get into that later, ladies and gentlemen. So, sit back, strap in, and be inspired. A la baby mucho gusto.
Yeah, I swear this gon' fuck the summer up. Niggas hang on me cause I'm coming up. Fuck you all night, we ain't gon' stop till the sun is up.
Number one, the name J.I. was given to him by his uncle. So, as you know, his first name is Justin. His middle name is Ivan, which is his dad's name as well. Yeah, boy, yes, he's Ivan Jr., ladies and gentlemen. So, they call him what? His uncle called him J.I., Justin Irvin. Bam, ladies and gentlemen. So, yeah. And the Prince of New York Parts was his Instagram handle when he was still a youngin' trying to make it to the rap game. And when he got to the rap game, people caught up to it and called him what? The Prince of New York one time. Number two, his mom was his manager. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, his mom, who was a bus driver and currently has a certificate in radio broadcasting and writing engineering, ladies and gentlemen, was his manager back when he was 14 at the start of his career and has been his manager throughout the rap game and after that. But now his current manager is Mr. Gabi, and he's helped him manage to get deals and sign checks off a meal, ladies and gentlemen. Bam, 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 one time. Number three, when he got booed off stage, he almost quit music. In 2017, he got booed off stage and he stopped making music. And man, remember, back then he was still 14 and he had people throwing things at him and trying to attack him, man. That broke his innocence, that brought him down, that broke his spirits and brought him to a what? A depression, ladies and gentlemen. He says he built up a lot of anger, man, and the thoughts kept playing over and over in his head. And then, man, he stopped writing and making music for a minute, man. You know what? Then one day when he was with his dad, man, chilling there by the park, he got some sort of rush of inspiration, ladies and gentlemen, and wanted to come back into the hip-hop game that he loved and admired. So, he hits up Mr. Gabi in 2019, and as we know in 2019, man, most tracks came out, tracks like Need Me, Blame On Me, I Done Lost Many Niggas and It's Crazy, that track, hey, ladies and gentlemen, hey, he even opened for A Boogie with the hoodie, ladies and gentlemen. And the grind was on. He released the what? The Hood Life Krisis mixtape, ladies and gentlemen. Damn. Shout out to J.R. He's been grinding like a morpho. Yes, ladies and gentlemen. One time. Number four, his favorite movie is 8 Mile, man. He says he loved the movie 8 Mile from since he was a young man and gets inspiration from what? Eminem. His favorite rappers are Eminem, Drake, Tupac, Nas, J. Cole, Snoop Dogg, Yes Man, and many other more. And he says the movie 8 Mile, you know, inspired him and made him what? A battle rapper. It made him want to conquer and devour. You know what I'm saying? Go to the streets and battle rap his ass to the top, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, and battle rap his ass to the top. Yeah, man. His favorite movie is what? 8 Mile, one time. Number five, he signed to G-Star and Interscope, ladies and gentlemen. He says when he signed to Interscope, he put more pressure on himself, man, and made music that is expressing his true feelings, ladies and gentlemen. So what people can relate to the things he's saying, man. He says he locked himself up in the studio for 2 weeks, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, and after locking himself out, he came out with the masterpiece named Hood Life Krisis, ladies and gentlemen. No, it ain't your childhood Krisis. It's the Hood Life Krisis, ladies and gentlemen. And what? That EP gave him the keys to own 2019 and 2020, ladies and gentlemen, with smash singles like what? Hood Scars, Blame It On Me, Need Me, Damn, ladies and gentlemen. Shout out to J.I. one time. Number six, he used to sell books to get fed, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, as we know, Mr. J.R. grew up in poverty, man. So sometimes he had to sell books that he wasn't reading and movies that he wasn't watching, man, so he could get food, man. And he used to live off the EBT food stamps. So when they didn't come along, he had to go sell them things to what? To get fed, to get the whole family fed, ladies and gentlemen. And then he says he didn't want to live broke. Yeah, man, it made him feel uncomfortable. At the age of 12, it made him feel uncomfortable, man. And he wanted to what? To be rich. He knew where he was headed. He wanted to become an entertainer, a rapper, a kingpin, ladies and gentlemen. Whew, one time. Number seven, he attended Ford Hamilton High School. Yeah, well, ladies and gentlemen, so yeah, man, the boy used to play basketball. Yes, as short as the man is, he used to play b-ball, man, and he quit when he didn't make the middle school team, man. So yeah, continued doing studies, man, and then what's focused on rap, and look at him now, major superstar, ladies and gentlemen. And he's currently 19, so last year he got his what? His diploma. One time, ladies and gentlemen. Number eight, he was on the Rap Game Season 2, the show hosted by Jermaine Dupri, JD. Yes, man, was a show on Lifetime, and it's a 10 to 13 week boot camp, like a rap boot camp, you dig, where young artists get exposure to the real life grind of the rap game, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, man. They have to compete against each other to get signed to what? To So Def, man. It showed them the cutthroat industry, ladies and gentlemen. So while he was on the show, man, he was killing everybody, man. Yeah, from the tracks to the battle raps to the music videos, he was killing Alice, man. But in the end, a guy named Manny ended up winning, man. So yeah, after that, Mr. J.I. got some press time with Hot 97, he got on the cover of Next Level magazine, and he graced the cover of Hip Hop Weekly, man. Damn, this kid, legend, J.I. Number 9, he is 5'8", ladies and gentlemen. Yes, Mr. J.I. J-I is quite short, man. You know, them short niggas are vowels, man. You know how it is. They say dynamite comes in small packages, and that is what he is, ladies and gentlemen. Woo, he is a machine, a tank, a killer. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, one time. And shout out to all my short people, and I'm also short. One time. Number 10. I just want the money, nigga. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, his net worth is $500,000. Yes, ladies and gentlemen. So, thank you for tuning in again, man. So, one time, man, shout out to J.I. And you know how it is. We kill it every time. It's Allah, baby. Mucho gusto. One time.